chain or drive shaft. In this video, instead of focusing on the pros and cons of each one of the options, I will ask you to look at the whole picture and see what is the conception of an adventure trip. Stay with me. Welcome back in the channel, guys. Before I start talking, I want to let you know that I don't have any goals to change the opinion or the beliefs you already have. Instead of that, I'm gonna show you the facts that you might miss it already and to show you, as I promised, the full picture of an adventure trip. First of all, I want to clarify that there is no such a thing like the best system. Each one is designed with a specific purpose. For example, we know that the drive shaft is better for long asphalt roads, but it has some limitations when it's coming to off-road riding. On the other hand, the chain is good for road, off-road, any kind of terrains, but it requires a lot of maintenance and usually wear very quick. These are the obvious things and I'm not gonna talk about it. Videos like this you can find thousands in YouTube. As usual, guys, I will show you a different perspective, a different way to see the whole picture. It may take a little bit longer, but this is the only way I know. So be patient and watch the whole video, because I promise until the end, you will get the information you need. Let's do it. Adventure trip. What exactly does this mean? For one person, it could be to go around the world and ride the most difficult terrains. For the second, to go on the 2 days trip on the nearest town. Some people love off-road, some people hate it. First and very important is to find out what exactly you want, what exactly you need. You have to understand that my or anyone's opinion, it doesn't matter, because at the end you are going to ride this motorcycle and you are going to have the positives or the negatives of the choice you have made. Pavlin, the video is supposed to be about the chain or drive shaft. Why are you talking again about the bike choice? You love this topic, aren't you? Because, guys, the choice you're going to make will determine what you're gonna have, chain or drive shaft. If you're still confused, keep watching and I will give you more details. If you love to have this massive adventure motorcycle and ride on the highways with 160 kilometers per hour and load a lot of luggage and to have this possibility to ride in some smooth gravel roads, the drive shaft is the perfect solution for you. On the other hand, if you're looking for a real adventure trip with as small as possible dirt rides and off-road riding, it is very obvious that you will need a chain. And now, on this point of the video, I expect a lot of drive shaft owners to send a lot of comments and telling me that it's not a problem to ride on off-road at all, to show me some pictures to prove where they've been and many more like this. But with the same result, guys, I can show you a lot of pictures from people who are thinking that the drive shaft is okay and then they learn it the hard way. Anyway, I'm not gonna discuss their choice. I hope that you got the idea. If you are not, I will explain a little bit longer. Everybody know, or at least 90% of the riders will tell you exactly the same, that you ride off-road, you need as light as possible motorcycle with good suspension and the right wheels combination, right? So far, most of you will agree with me. You will also confirm that 21-inch front wheel is much better for off-roading, because the bigger size of the wheel will help you to absorb the bumps, the holes and all the obstacles much easier than smaller wheel. So far, so good. But now I have a question for you guys. Can you show me a big adventure motorcycle with nice suspension, 21-inch front wheel and drive shaft on the back? I honestly never seen this combination, but it might exist in some very rare models. Anyway, usually the drive shafts are installed on the motorcycles with 17 or 19-inch front wheel, something like a GS1200 and many other models. So if you're one of those guys who want to have this big and heavy adventure motorcycle and ride it with 160 kilometers per hour on the highways and still be able to go and make some off-road riding, I will suggest, instead of GS1200 Adventure, to go for KTM 1290 Adventure, which is already with a chain. And all of this actually eliminates the question what to take, chain or drive shaft. Just to make it even more clear, guys, I will let you know that when you have this combination 21-inch front wheel and chain on the back, you will be able to ride much faster and safer on the dirt roads and bad roads compared to the drive shaft. The reason of that is that when you stand on the pegs, like me now, and remove your own weight from the rear side of the motorcycle, the only weight left over there will be the bike itself. So when you're riding, standing on the pegs like this, your rear will jump like a goat from side to side and up and down all the time. And the lighter it is, the easier it's going to be for you to control the bike. Another one very important moment to consider is the possibility to fix it if something goes wrong. For example, if it's breakdown. Chains are easy to fix. You can find chains almost everywhere. Chains and sprockets are even cheaper. And as I said, you can find it everywhere around the world. It is not the same with the drive shafts. Yes, they break down very rare, but when it happens, you actually stuck until you find the proper parts. And if you're in some places like Asia, for example, or Africa, you need to wait for shipping, and it might take even more than a month, and then you need a special people to fix it, and all of this could be really, really complicated and difficult to fix problem when you're on the trip. So for me, guys, it's absolutely clear that I don't need anything else than a simple chain. Yeah, I have to spray it once per 500 kilometers, maybe clean it once per 2,000 or 3,000 kilometers, and change it every 20,000, but what? I do it even with pleasure. For me, it's very, very important to have the right combination when I hit the bad roads, the adventure roads, when I have to rely on this motorcycle, because reliability is everything. And also I have to be able to fix it if something goes wrong, because I'm not of one of these rich guys which are just will make one phone call and all the parts and all the service and all the mechanics will come to the place. So I need to rely. That's why this is my opinion. I prefer the chain, but yours could be absolutely different, and I perfectly understand and respect that. So guys, after everything I just said, should be easy to take the right decision, but if you're still confused, watch this video here. It is about the bike choice, and this one on the bottom about the chain maintenance. As usual, thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Check also my Instagram account, Motorcycle Adventures, and see you next time. Ciao.